Hello and welcome back to Let's Play The Settlers 2 10th birthday, 10th anniversary. I will have to find a better way to call this game, so we will just say The Settlers for now. Last time we finished the mission 1, it was pretty easy. We didn't even start to make an economy, etc. But mission 2 should be a bit different, so let's start it. Fast loading.
The land of the Nile. A warm breeze murmured overhead, whispering things in a strange language only it could understand. This place was as arid and dusty as our homeland after the many years of drought, but also much warmer. On closer inspection, some plants and animals seemed to have adapted themselves to this climate admirably. Either the effects of global warming were extremely pronounced in these parts, or the mysterious portal had taken us very far away from home.
It must be global warning, I suppose. yes, I always forget that the key combination is a bit different in this game. So, okay. The goal for now, we are here. We must arrive here, where is the next portal to the next world. But I guess we will probably meet some enemies in this time, I suppose. Otherwise, it would be very, very easy. So, we should have a strong economy. I see there is some rocks over here, which would be very interesting because we probably don't have a lot. Let's have a look at our stock first. Nah, that's okay, 68 and 44. We also have a lot of dessert around. Dessert. Arid place. And we should build a small area to farm trees around here because we have rocks there too, because it seems easier to grow. So I will build a barracks first to extend my way to this place, to this rock. I will have a forester in the middle, and on the side I will have a woodcutter. Not a forester. A woodcutter. Yes, I can link them. And then I have to link everything to my main headquarter. Perfect. I want also to have directly, I will start making supply of fish because we have some fish around here probably. It won't last a long time, but it will already be a short supply for my starting business. And I will need a sawmill. So let's destroy this and do it like that. Yes, very good. That's the very starting. I will probably directly go and build a second sawmill because I will destroy the full complete wood around here. Woodcutter. And we have a lot of sign again and showing a direction here again. So it's probably the way we have to go to fetch the portal without going next to a mountain, etc. I never noticed them before, so it's brand new for me. I will send some geologists as well to have a little information about the land surroundings, and we can definitely play in a faster game speed, probably 3 times. We don't need to go slower for now. Okay, very good. Today I watched the new episode of Doctor Who. This sign is making me think about it, so those who knows about that episode will understand. It's a 1st April of 2013, and the episode was about Wi-Fi. So I don't know how we will do to expand that way. I will probably build a small barrack around here, so it will be able to extend the border a bit more. What's new? We have fisherman hu fisher fishem fisherman hut, which is built. The forester one, and one of the woodcutter, and there is coal around here, which is quite nice, quite nice. That's the only place we can build it right now, but once we will push the border, we will have a better spot to put it, probably. I hope. Yeah, not much better, because we should push this side as well. The barracks built here won't make it push, but maybe I can start putting a barracks down here already. So this area will keep it to grow trees. I need to very quickly go and fetch the quarry here. I still have a bit of trees here, but I want to build a starting farm area as well. Or maybe the farm area will be around here. Okay, a lot of message that I don't want to see right now. The boulder have been pushed a bit. What do we have around here? We have another quarry, so apparently we will not be lacking any kind of stone for now and for a while. I want also to have a quite stable economy, so I was just checking my time. So I will probably build, as soon as we go a bit too far away, I will start building a storehouse. Like this one. So, military building completed, and now we have access to a lot of place for the coal. So I believe it's better to build the coal in the middle of other coal place. It will have more coal under it, and will get out of coal much slower. So we can already start taking coal, because we need it, and we have iron here. Very good. So iron is the next that we want. And we will upgrade also the border around here. And try to start a little industry of tools first. So, the coal is down here. The iron is up here. Maybe we can have a small tool industry around this place. But wait, this is derpy. This is better. Thank you. So, first of all, I want to smelt the iron into iron bars. Then I want to have a smithy creating tools. And after that, if there is stuff left, I would like to have... Oh no, the metalwork is creating tools and the smithy is creating weapons. Okay. Anyway, I need the three of them. So go ahead and start building with that. I will join here directly, make a direct connection from the coal to those places. And here we have a storehouse building, so we can join it too. It will be a much more efficient way to go wherever they want. We have a barracks which is manned. So the place around here looks quite nice and quite green. So maybe what I will do is start cutting down all the trees, and later on we will be able to create farms. So first of all, I will start to create a woodcutter again. Very good. I have a little seaside again here. Once again, it has a lot of green pasture, but I want to be able to take fish first. Here I can probably start already building my first farm. Maybe it's not the good place. Here it would be better. And this farm will...
While expanding our boundaries in a northwesterly direction, we encountered the local inhabitants for the first time. The skin of the people living here was much darker than that of us seafarers. Judging from the language and the clothes of the strangers, we had to be in the land of the Nile. Yet, this was completely impossible. Unfortunately, the people here were not very hospitable towards us. The tracks from the old ruins led us directly to their camp, however, and there were indications that another portal existed.
Okay, so we encountered the first enemies. It's good and bad news at the same time, but I didn't quite understood where. Probably on the top there. We will see. We will see. I will keep extending my areas, but here I will extend with a watchtower, so we will have a much greater territory and also much greater power for everyone, just to be on the safe side. Okay, my farm around here will be very nice. As soon as I cut everything, I will extend a little bit around this place as well, so I can access this water and build a new fisherman, because fishermen are a quite cheap source of food for the beginning. On the bottom, same situation, I could extend. I don't want to extend too much though, not too much. We could have a new wood cutting area around here, because this one is not going to grow very fast. But let's try to do that. If I have a forester hut here and a woodcutter, that's a forester again. I said woodcutter. I can probably plop a second woodcutter. Plop, I'm speaking like SimCity. And I will need a storehouse around here, because people have to go far away to store materials. Storehouse is there now. If I build this like that, oh, that's kind of ugly. Like this. And I could build the storehouse here instead. It's a much better place. Okay, very good. So I have my woodcutter, and here I can extend my borders. I will send directly someone to a geologist to see what's in the ground here. I should really change the key combination. Oh, I can do it like that. Okay, that works too. Okay. Everything is going fine. Maybe I should boost a bit the speed where we cut the tree around here, so I could also add one more woodcutter. Just for now, it's a temporary one. So for now, there's not too much action, but this game will have action sooner or later. You will see. I don't know, I believe they are here around. It's quite nice to look anyway, but even for 2006 game, it was very good, very interesting. Autosave. Gold! Oh, that's wonderful. I'm happy about that. So we should probably make a second coal mine here, because we will need much more coal than what we have. And we can start mining gold. So the gold way, the way gold is working is... may I do that? So basically you have gold ore and coal ore, and you combine them in a mint to make gold pieces. And then your pieces are sent to your coins, are sent to the barracks and military buildings to upgrade the rank of military working there. So you have to be very cautious about where you send the gold, etc., because you want to have an efficient building for that. For instance, it's much more interesting to have gold going to a watchtower than going to barracks, because there's much more people there. So what I will do is disable the cutoff, the fact that I want gold here. I will also evacuate the building, so because I don't really have enemies around here, and I want to focus mainly all my military around my borders. Very cool. So I'm doing that about everywhere. We didn't quite fetch the enemy borders yet, so I believe I may have had the message about discovering the enemies a bit too fast. So I'm getting the stone around here, and I start to have really a lot of messages. So evacuate this building, and we have water, and we have some place to mine. But I won't evacuate this building, I will upgrade it because it will extend the border a little bit more and I will be able to place another military building around here. So the stuff I want to have right now is it would be interesting for me to start building a fortress where I can have a lot of militaries sitting around and upgrading them there, only there. So this is a nice place to farm as well. And this is shiny, so it seems interesting. So I will build my stronghold here, and it will also greatly increase my borders. All of my militaries are going crazy and saying, yay, we have people. I will extend. Keep extending, it's my way in this game, and if we meet someone, then we will take actions. Extending this way as well. So we have the farm right now, but we don't have anything that use the farm, that use the production from the farm. So I will directly start building those kind of stuff. So the first thing I want would be to make bread. So I want a mill and I want a bakery. I cannot join it anywhere yet. Indeed, this will do. This will do. The mill and the bakery also need a well. So we have the well here, and I will build it. This can be much better, I believe. Wait. Can I destroy this, please? Okay. Yeah, I prefer that. It makes more sense for me. It's a lot of little intersection, but it gives option to the goods about the pathfinding, so it's okay, it's good, nice. This road is used a lot, and it also has a donkey, so maybe I can remove a few of the weight from that road to go this way. Military building is being filled and manned again, and I will remove everything. So this map seems much, much bigger than the previous one, and there's quite a lot of place to fetch and make farms to make food, so it's okay. I will keep expanding though. I'm not sure I have to, maybe I'm losing a bit of time here and there, but okay, we will see, we will see. This building has been filled as well. And yeah, nothing there, nothing really interesting. My chain of production start to be very long. I don't really like that a lot, and my stocks. I don't have a lot of planks, but I have a lot of logs, so I could basically improve the number of sawmill I have. But probably I should build there around this place where I'm cutting a lot of trees. Also, there seems to be less and less tree for now around here, so can I relocate the production? No, I cannot relocate the production here. It's in another Sims, another settlers. I will have a storehouse again here and a sawmill, just for the sake of it. And yeah, like that. Perfect. I know I have a storehouse already here, but I don't. Yeah, it's okay. It will work. I don't need this road anymore. No resource found. Okay, so the quarry is over. I will destroy the building and it will bring me back some of the planks, etc. So it's better to destroy the building before removing the roads, so you get back the planks. So I have a lot of areas here. And maybe I want to build a second forester hut to have more trees. This building didn't find anything neither. It's a woodcutter and I can kill it because I wanted to get rid of the wood around here. So I'm improving the area. I will maybe stop a bit the expansion for now because I can really have whatever I want around here. Let's make some more fish, and yeah, go there. And this building has been fully manned as well. I should really start my progression towards the this place. But how is going my food production? So food production is okay, native 100% working bakery. This woodcutter will soon be out of work, so I can start building my second chain of supply, which will be one more farm, followed by this road will be destroyed. Yep, followed by a building cannot be built on this map. Okay, so we cannot make a pig on this map, unfortunately. So let's have more farms then. Do I want it going here? Yeah. Okay, we will be crazy on the bread then. And the storehouse here. Oh yeah, it's two of them, but it's okay. I will need probably a few more buildings, like a new mill, because this one is already working completely, and a new bakery. I think I'm okay in water situation, water-wise, but we never know. It may be a good idea to have one more well in a greenish place. So let's have one around here. This road will be an issue for the farm, so I will redraw it. And we have this building filled. So what I want to have as much people as I want here. As I'm controlling which towers get what, militaries or not, and I guess I say to every one of them, every single one of them, that I don't want military in them, I can come in my settings here and say that even if I'm very far away from the enemies, I want to have the maximum amount of people. So you see here, they bring one coin and it's already upgraded to this one to sergeant. And up, officer. So it will keep coming, and normally from my HQ I should have a line of military going to make this place complete of military people. Very cool. Very cool. So, something I didn't check since a while is, okay, Metalwork and Smithy are only working 60% because they are lacking of iron. And indeed, we don't produce a lot of iron. We just have one mine and it's only working at 80%, probably because of the food, etc. But woodcutter is empty. Okay. I can deal with that. Okay, I was saying probably because of the food situation, but I should be able to find different place where I can have iron. And can I keep upgrading this? No, I go away. So here we had coal, here we had metal ore, maybe here it's iron. Send a geologist. Where else do we have some mines? Mine place? Here we never went and it was shiny, so maybe we should go there and have a look. Here we could try to see what's there already before having the border. And I will keep extending this side. Oh, we have of course a big place where we can send a geologist as well, around here. And this place too. So we have a few buildings completed. Go away, thank you. I have to click 500 times. What did you find? Stone would be interesting, but we don't lack stone for now. So what I will do, just as an information keeper, I will directly come here and build a stone mine, but I won't connect it, so it won't be built. I will build also a flag here and send another geologist. We have some more coal, which is a very good situation because we need much more coal than what we have. So those two mines, I will already connect them. And we could have around here a storehouse because this one is a bit far away, and also some fishing going on. So storehouse and fisherman. Thank you. So this will be a quite little interesting mining area. We could also start having some food down here, but it's very far away from the rest. So coal was there. Gold? Okay, this is gold. Very cool. I will build it directly because the coal, I want to take it whenever I can. Some more coal. So we have coal here, we have gold. We could produce some coins directly just next to the stronghold, so it will be very difficult for the enemy to steal it if they ever try. And I will redo my roads around here like that. Okay, so we have the storehouse and everything. Oh, military. Okay, it's just a building being built, and it would be interesting to take the stone from here. I'm just having a time, so okay, in 4 minutes I will stop. Evacuate this building again. I don't need to have people around here. And if we look here, we already have some generals, 4 of them. So if I want to keep having new generals made around here, I can come to my HQ and say, hey guys, I want you to keep generals in my HQ. So we will be able to see those generals here. Going out, or maybe not. I have to evacuate and say, okay, you can come back. There's a trick to do that. So for now, I'm evacuating the building. All the generals, is the one with the gold stuff, etc., are going out, and then now I can say, okay, everyone can come back. But as those generals will go back to the HQ to fulfill my order to keep some generals there, they should not come back. But they are going not to the HQ, but to the storehouse. I wonder if this will be working. It seems to be. 0 out of 15. But the generals are not coming up again. Yes, so this worked. I have a few generals probably hanging in this entrepot, in this storage for now, and they will slowly go to the HQ. Lots of building being built, very good. And there is iron, what we were searching for. So, I should take this place, but I will need a small building around, military building to take this. And no resource found. Okay, of course, it's a woodcutter that we use to clean the farming area. How is the production of bread going? Can I see that somewhere? I'm not used to the interface yet, so bear with me. That's not the button, that's not the button. I suppose it must be around here. Food. Okay. So, I'm producing quite a lot of food, about 3, and I'm not consuming them fast enough. Okay, I think that's what they want to do, to say. No resources found, quarry. This can go away as well. There's a little bit here, but it's okay. And this is very cool, because we can get rid of this road and it will provide more space for this farm, which is only at 90% for now. And we have our new mints produced, so we will start producing even more gold coin. And this one is 95%, it's really cool. 95, we still don't produce a lot of stuff. And why is this Mitty stopped? Did I ask him to stop? No, because it doesn't have metal, yeah. And this is because it doesn't have coal right now. So, okay, the metal situation is not the big issue anymore. It's mostly the coal one. This one is stopped because it doesn't have food. So, in next episode, we will have to provide more food, make a more stable economy to produce metal. And once we will have metal producing, we have to produce some beer as well, so we will be able to produce more soldiers. Here we have two more generals again, and I hope you enjoy. See you on next episode. Bye bye.